working as an associate professor in University School of Information and Communication Technology, DGS IT University, since February 2012. He has joined IT University as a lecturer in July 2001 and promoted to senior lecturer in July 2006. He obtained PhD in Information Technology from IT University Delhi in 2011. He has worked in the area of artificial neural networks and M.Tech from Guru Chandrasekhar University, Hisar. He has also worked as a lecturer in University of Hyderabad and Balasari Vidyapeeth. His areas of interest are artificial neural networks, embedded system design, and digital system design. He has published more than 30 research papers in international and national journals and attended various national and international workshops and seminars. Dr. Singh visited UK, Portugal and Singapore to present his research work in international conferences. CTJ team honored with your presence, sir.
Moving ahead, we would like to introduce our guest speaker for this technical session, Dr. Namita Rajput, who is an associate professor in Sri Aurobindo College, University of Delhi. Dr. Rajput has a doctorate from University of Delhi. She holds the MPhil degree and postdoctoral research fellowship. She has 23 years of rich experience in teaching, lecturing, and research and development, with specialization in finance, international business, marketing, and other subjects in commerce. She has proficiency in handling graduate, postgraduate students, and research scholars, and has been actively participating in various seminars and presentations, and has authored several books and papers in national and international journals. She has received numerous awards for presenting her research work in national and international conferences. She believes that teachers take their cues from the current education landscape, where technological innovations and globalization have led to their growth. We are privileged to have you with us, ma'am. Can we have a round of applause, please?
Now we shall have a moment of felicitation. May we request Mr. Ivan Satumedi and Ms. Neha Mittal to kindly felicitate the guest of honor, Dr. Amit Prasad Singh, session chair.
Conference, that is, what are the emerging issues in business and technology.
So there is a lot of dynamism which we see in the modern context. There is globalization, as you've seen, and the advent of globalization started way back in 1991 with the process of de-licensing, liberalization, privatization, etc. So since then, the climate, the dynamism, the overall strategies which have been adopted by the business sector, it has been changing every now and then. Now we see that there are lot of strategic alliances. We are now talking about when the scenario started with the LPG strategies, that is liberalization, privatization and globalization, that overall context in the way we do business, the modus operandi which was adopted in the yesteryear are no more present here. Now more specifically, I talk about the advent of information and technology. Now in the previous scenario when we talk about, we used to have a brick business, that is we need to have a business and there was one receptionist sitting on the counter, and overall the business environment was like a very conventional and traditional environment. But now, because of this technology, because of this changes in the technology, the way we do is different. The way we do the business is altogether different. Now even your home can be converted into a place of work. So when you talk about this, the office is no more a place. It is the overall the work. You can convert even your present chair in which you are sitting as your office. What you need is the connectivity of the internet, the broadband, and the software and the hardware in the form of the laptop. So this is, the kind of changes which are so stringent, which has taken place, because of which there is a lot of mileage which we see. Now you see when you have to go out in the yester concept of the business, you used to take out your car and you used to reach your workplace, and there was the use of diesel, there is a lot of congestion on the roads. But yet now, there are a lot of multinational corporations which they allow you from business, and I mean, you can operate from home. And more specifically, I talk about the IBM. IBM is a very good IT company in which they allow all the employees to work from home. So what they need is every time they log in, they are given a one-time password. So you can log in through that, and the basic thing which you want is the connectivity, and throughout connectivity, and this is how and when it happens because of the advent of information technology. Now I come on to the corporate sector. The corporate sector has also seen a lot of changes because of this, the present scenario. Like for example, the ROC, that is the Register of Companies, everything is done through computers. So they have to do e-filing. You can see the type of the income tax also you file. It is all converted into e. Even the courts are slowly moving on to the e-courts. So this saves time, this saves money, this saves effort. Now, more specific changes which are talking about is the environmental change. Anybody who knows specifically that what is the great situation which we are facing today? Any one word, I need the word from the students. That what is the major problem which we are facing because of the environmental changes?
Global warming.
Perfect. So this is the kind of effort we all are moving towards, because we do not have any planet B. We have to save this planet. We have to put all our best endeavors to reduce the carbon footprint. So the climate change is the major problem because of which we have to strategize. We have to change the way we do business. So all the corporates are moving towards the decarbonization of the economy. And this is a kind of, the footprint which they are trying to reduce, which is going to increase the sustainability aspect. So people are, doing the business responsibly. There is a strategic transformation. Strategic transformation is a compulsory transformation from the way we do business. So what is included in the present context is the kind of environmental issues are most important for them. And the people have understood that yes, greed is no more into the roots of the business. It is the social cause which is entering into the heart.
heart and the mind of the people, because of which there is a great endeavor of transformation from socially responsible mission. Every now and then we talk about the changes which are taking place in terms of the corporate social responsibility. Anyone and everyone knows about it, that the corporate social responsibility, the Indian Act of the companies, it has also passed this, and they have clubbed the sustainability and the CSR issues as one. So you have to exhibit in terms of the reporting to the corporate sector that yes, this is the resources which you have used, and this is the technology which you have used, and you have to be, you know, very, very particular in terms of the corporate governance practices. When you talk about the reporting practices, that this is the scenario of today. So there is a clear transparency which we are looking forward for the modern corporate sector because of these emerging issues in the management and the IT. And of course, this development of environmentalism, that is toxic, waste, the industrial waste, which is, when you specifically talk about the Indian country, when you specifically talk about the India, that this is the scenario which is more grey in India because we are not that responsible. Like if we are going out to the foreign countries, we will never spit. We will, take care of the environment because there are a lot of checks and balances which are imposed in the foreign countries. So there is a need, and our Prime Minister has started with the many new schemes for Swachh Bharat Abhiyan because of the environmental issues, because of the all these schemes which have been started and initiated by the government of India, they have a direct spillover on the kind of the business which we do and the way we have to do. Not only this, when you talk about the climate change, there is a strategic transformation which is mandatory and a part of the organization set up of today. Now let's talk about the management practices. The management practices of the corporate sector, there are also a lot of changes. I have been mentioning so many issues because these are the major issues which we talk about. So now I am coming on to a minor identity, that is the corporate sector. So first, let me talk about the corporate sector in which we are now allowing the green practices. The green practices in terms of that you can acknowledge in the organization, you will be interviewed electronically, maybe a FaceTime activity or video conferencing. So this is definitely going to reduce the footprint. You need not go to Mumbai because the head office was in Mumbai. So you can just log on to the website, give your presence on the network, and then you are selected or deselected. Similarly, there are a lot of energy efficiency techniques which we are looking forward for. Like people across the globe, they are, when they open their offices in terms of, so they are having a green building. And these certifications are also given to them that yes, they are using a combination of the natural light and the CSL and the energy saving techniques. And they are doing the recycling also for the paper. So the reduce, reuse, etc. The three are reduction of the resources because they are very, very less, and you have to optimize that, you have to reuse them, and again you have to deploy them. So now there are a lot of endeavors which are moving on from 3 hours to maybe 5 hours, maybe to 7 hours. So this is what the major difference which we talk about today, that is the kind of the business, the strategic importance of energy saving techniques. What is at the back of this mind? The back of this mind is the climate change. To my knowledge and to my extent, whatever are the issues which the management and the, because of the advent of information and communication technologies which we are looking forward, the backdrop is the climate change. So as a matter of fact, you are definitely going to enter your reality life when you will be actually working or you will be young entrepreneurs. So you have to be very careful in selecting your business because there is an analysis called environmental impact analysis in which we do a lot of, there are some bodies which are responsible for giving the certification in terms of whether you do your business in a clean way or a bad way. So clean is the green and clean environment is the need of today. We have to preserve the environment, we have to contain the environment, and we have to be very responsible to increase the sustainability aspect of the business. Now there are a lot of, if you see the literature, if you see the news which is happening around the globe, that the companies which are actually doing business in a clean and green way, you see a lot of empirical evidences to this effect that their profits are also rising. So it's not